I rise as a proud American who has the distinct honor of serving in this great body. As a member of Congress, we take an oath to defend the Constitution because at times it needs defending. On January 6th, the nation watched as insurrectionists stormed the Capitol, threatening the safety of countless individuals and successfully, albeit temporarily, disrupting our process. In the midst of the attack, hundreds of Capitol police officers heroically upheld their duty to defend the United States and protect those who work here. Many officers were severely injured and beaten, including one of my former interns. And tragically, one officer, Officer Brian Sicknick, succumbed to the injuries he sustained. To Officer Sicknick's family, I extend my deepest condolences and know that we are praying for you. And to all Capitol Police officers, we are deeply thankful for your bravery. Because of you, thousands of lives were protected and the people's work was able to resume. Now, just as the Capitol Police protected us, Congress must match that courage and protect the Constitution, our democratic processes, and this nation. The President's role in this insurrection is undeniable, both on social media ahead of January 6th and in his speech that day. He deliberately promoted baseless theories, creating a combustible environment of misinformation and division. To allow the President of the United States to incite this attack without consequences is a direct threat to the future of this democracy. For this reason, I will vote to impeach this President tomorrow. The bill before us tonight is a non-binding resolution, which requests the Vice President to invoke the 25th Amendment, a step he has already said he will not take. It is merely a symbolic gesture, and I will oppose that resolution. After last week's attack on the Capitol, it is clear our nation is more divided than ever in recent history. We began this great experiment over 240 years ago, and to preserve it, we must remember that our faith, race, or political party is not what unites us. What unites us is that we are Americans. I'd encourage members of this body and everyone at home to remember that simple truth. And with that, I yield back.
Hey, NBC News viewers, thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on that button down here and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives. Thanks for watching.